Good afternoon. So over the last few years at RSA, you know, we've heard many speakers talk about the Moneyball story. In fact, I understand that Billy Bean has been on this very stage a number of times. But today, I'm very excited to talk to you about how to translate that story into real benefit for users and customers using a quantitative approach to data and security. So as we know, the threat landscape continues to get worse. And to mitigate this threat landscape, we continue to increase the complexity of our software solutions and our security environment. And especially at this conference, we see a vast array of vendors introducing new technologies that they claim is the one solution. These technologies include deception, system lockdown, patch management, firewalls, next-generation firewalls, sandboxing, AV, web application firewalls, flying toasters, and many other things. In fact, some large enterprises have 60 to 70 individual security products in their environment. Think about that, 60 to 70. How do you manage the complexity of the interaction between all these products? Because each of these products has a ton of features. That's how people compete. Each of these products has a ton of settings and configuration. The challenge we have is that we do not have unlimited time or unlimited budget. So it's critical to make some really hard choices. What product should I buy? Should I upgrade? What policies can I set for my individual users? Are my security settings right? How do I know? Ultimately, what is the ROI for each possible option I can choose across all these products, all these vendors, all these settings? And how much budget do I need? And unfortunately today, these set of choices, these decisions, is much more an art than a science. So we've got to ask ourselves, is there a better way? There's got to be a better way. It turns out a similar question was addressed yesterday. You know, the question was, hey, can we use these analytical techniques, this big data stuff that we keep hearing about, and a quantitative approach, can we use these techniques to achieve a better outcome? Yesterday, we talked about baseball. But what about security? Now, it turns out some years ago, the Oakland A's had an idea. What if we applied data analytics on a wide array of attributes to quantitatively determine the best team for a given budget? The idea was to move the choice of the team from an art to a science, and we all know it worked. So much so that pretty much every sport has a team that is using Moneyball principles to put together their dream team. And now there are entire conferences and scholarly papers that are written, that are assembled, where people discuss how do I use analytical approaches to build the best sports teams. This is the world we want to create for security. This is the world we want to enable for all of us tackling these tough issues and how do we set up systems to protect our enterprises, our customers. And by the way, it's happening now. In the next several months, you will see actual products that leverage the story, that leverage these concepts to enable a new breed of capability and choices and ability for customers and IT professionals worldwide. Imagine that you could optimize your security decisions based on real data and mathematical analysis. Imagine the model could tell you what specific products and vendors would have the highest efficiency in your environment. You know, the previous speaker talked about how certain metrics showed you how encryption would result in a lower breach ratio. But how can you customize that further so that that is true not just for an industry or for the security landscape as a whole, but for you? Because you, as we all know, each of us has a different environment. Each of us has a different topology, different users, different behaviors, different data sets that are of different interest to attackers. How do we figure out what the right policies and the right settings to choose are? And imagine if this model could even tell you what to focus on first to have the biggest budget impact. How do we do it? Well, we start by first collecting information about your environment. And we collect demographic information so that we could customize the result based on you, your geography, your industry. We'd collect information on outcomes. How often are attackers getting through into your enterprise? How long does it take to detect them, to remediate? What were the attackers trying to access? What machines were targeted? Did they eat cookies? How many hours a day are your security professionals spending staring at consoles? And we'd collect this information about your specific environment as well. What security products and from what vendors do you have deployed? Do you have firewalls? Do you have IPS? Do you have endpoint AV? Do you have server lockdown? And much more. Furthermore, how have you configured your products? What firewall ports do you have open? How sensitive is your DLP? What cloud apps are your employees accessing? Is whitelisting enabled? Of course, we take all this data, we store it anonymously in the cloud. Super important that in order to scale this, you need to address the privacy concerns of customers. So you do want to store this anonymously in the cloud. Now, what's critical is that you collect this data not just from a single enterprise, but literally from hundreds of thousands of companies worldwide across geography, across industry, across size, across type, across pretty much every variable you can think of. The more data you have, the higher the accuracy of the result. In this regard, of course, it's critical to be able to leverage existing data stores. And we all know that today there exist many, many security repositories of threat information, of attack information, of malevolent actor information. And leveraging that is absolutely critical. For example, Symantec's global intelligence network is already the largest civilian threat intelligence platform in the world. Now what we do is we'd analyze this information using statistical techniques to find the impact of specific factors in your environment. So to do this, we could start with each demographic. We can measure, for example, for every setting in every product, what the outcome was across all enterprises using that setting. Now, for a specific company in a specific demographic with a specific environment, we can model which product should be deployed with what configuration to maximize the level of protection. And by intersecting this with product costs, you end up with ROI. You end up with a real ROI calculation. So let's discuss some examples. First, let's look at how we might determine the best technologies for an environment. As we discussed, doing this requires optimizing across a combination of environment, attackers, and user behavior. Now, again, it's super critical that we do this on a basis which is specific to your company. You can't do this in a generic way. So we start with the database in this example showing for a given demographic, customer products, settings, attackers' behaviors, and user behaviors, and the outcome, which in this case might be infection rates. Now, to be clear, you can optimize for many other things. You don't have to optimize for infection rates. You could say, what's really important to me right now is remediation time. Or what's really important to me is a fixed budget. Or many other things that might be important to your enterprise at that time. Using this data, we can run regression models to determine the efficacy of specific products and settings to a customer. For example, we can build a graph of the efficacy of different technology options for customer C in this example. Now, this would be continued to be refined as companies make changes to products and settings. As they make changes, the model gets updated. As the model gets updated, conceivably, the recommendation back to the company changes as well, or it evolves. So it's important that this is a real-time thing. As you've heard from many speakers today, the threat landscape is moving fast. In fact, it's accelerating, and you have to keep up. Old data is useless data. So in this example, customer C could run the analysis and find that their top three investments would be to patch a particular database vulnerability, turn on host-based IPS, and install honeypots. And that might be true for this particular customer. And we could also show predicted ROI based on cost and impact. Next, let's drill in more deeply into the customer's environment. So within an enterprise, there are often hotspots where the risk of the attack is greatest. These hotspots might exist because there's a server that stores credit card information. It might be because of user hygiene. It might be because you have internet-facing systems that are most susceptible to attack. To find these hotspots, again, you start with the data. In this case, on each department, asset type, machine, or user. We can then identify the hotspots where our data shows a disproportionate amount of risk. Why is this important? Well, it's important for two reasons. Number one, as we discussed, you have a finite budget. And you really don't want to peanut butter this budget across everything. Okay, because you have a finite budget, and you really want to apply it to places where there's greatest risk. But then number two, as we also know, security is one of those businesses where your users, your end users, expect security to be transparent. And to the extent you can determine places where there's lower risk, you can make security less intrusive. And so what this gives you an ability to do is say, let me balance security and let me apply the greatest security and the greatest policies and the most intrusive policies on places where it's really, really needed. So again, in this case, the quantitatively best approach may be to deploy restrictive, intrusive lockdown policies on specific outliers while deploying less restrictive settings on the majority of devices. So what's really exciting about this is that the mass customization, and again, this is for a particular enterprise based on their environment and their topology and their industry and the behavior of their own users. So this, what this mass customization allows you to do is allow the valuable resources, the valuable finite resources of the enterprise to be focused on the places that really matter, and this is based on real data. So what this could mean is deploying a more restrictive setting on, let's say, 5% of the total assets could dramatically reduce infection rates across the entire corporation while keeping the false alarms and the costs low. So finally, let's look at a third example. We were concerned about issues caused by deploying new technologies or settings. Now, you know, this is something that pretty much every customer I speak with has a concern about. Every large enterprise has thousands of products, thousands of IT applications, lots of existing stuff. And they're very, very concerned that if I install a new product, a new setting, a new thing, what's going to happen? Is it going to break things? Is it going to have a business impact? Is it going to disrupt my existing business? That seems to be the number one fear. Compatibility is a giant fear. That the change will result in an unforeseen outage that'll have a giant business impact. And then I'm going to spend a bunch of time scrambling and then reconvincing the business owners that security is good for them. What if you could predict this as well? For example, we could record every single time a customer enables, let's say, address space randomization, you know, which is one of the techniques used for protection. Okay, so let's say we record every time that happens, as well as details about the particular environment. What software did they have in use? What are the configurations? What are the user behaviors? And then we could correlate this with outcomes. In this case, how often did protected systems become unstable? And of course, you'd include things like what were the IT applications that were installed, how were they used, with what frequency, what was the user behavior. In this example, we see how this might work. Five different customers make the setting change. And in our database, we record this change and the outcomes. Then we can map this to a customer who's considering the change, using their specific environment and our global data to predict the issues that they will need to address. You know, from these examples, I hope you've seen how impactful Moneyball-style data analytics could be to our environment. The A's found a quantitative recipe for how to win with a very, very limited budget. Using it, they turned baseball upside down and changed the game forever. Not just the game of baseball, but sports. They opened the eyes of people to think, wow, this is not really about gut. This is not about experience. This is about using real data, finding the real attributes, and using that to make decisions that actually matter. Now, together, I hope using these techniques, we can do the same thing in the security arena. Thank you.